Police have filed criminal complaints against Congressman Arnulfo Tevez Jr. and six others over weapons seized from his properties. Our very own Rafi Santos now joins us with details. Rafi, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina. Earlier today, the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group of Philippine National Police has confirmed that it indeed filed cases against Representative Arnulfo Tevez and six others in connection with weapons and explosives found in separate raids into his properties on last March 10, 2023. According to the CIDG, Tevez has been charged with the violations of RA 10591, or the Comprehensive Firearms and Ammunition Regulation Act, and RA 9516, the Law on Explosives. Cases were also filed against Jose Pablo Guimarangan, Roland Pablio, and a secretary of Arnulfo Tevez, Hannah May, Heracleo Sangasin Oray, and Rodolfo Tevez Maturan, and Joseph Kyle Maturan were also charged with these same cases. According to the CIDG, six of these respondents have been brought to Metro Manila and have been inquested as part of the filing of the cases. Now, according to the CIDG, they are still awaiting what the prosecutors will do with these complaints, if they will file the necessary cases against these respondents. Right now, we are still trying to get a statement from the representative or the lawyer of Congressman Arnulfo Tevez with regards to these charges. Carmina.
All right, Rafi, just a quick question. The six others, what's their involvement here? What's their connection with those weapons seized in the congressman's properties?
Okay. Carmina, there were separate raids in different places in Negros Oriental on March 10, 2023. These were executed by the PNP CIDG, including the CIDG National Capital Region Field Unit. And according to the head of the National Capital Region Field Unit, Colonel Hansel Marantan, these people were inside the properties when they were the firearms were seized. Some of them, including one allegedly, is a secretary of the Congressman Arnulfo Tevez, and the other one is reportedly a gunman connected to Tevez. Details are murky as of the moment. Carmina, we have yet to see the filed papers with the prosecutor's office. The CIDG has promised to furnish us with copies of the said documents within today. And as soon as we get them, we will get back to you with more details. Carmina.
Finally, Rafi, what other info are your sources telling you? Your sources telling you that this is just the beginning, that there will be more cases filed against the congressman?
Okay. According to the CIDG statement today, just one complaint was filed against Congressman Tevez, but they are readying other charges against him. According to the CIDG, when we asked for clarification, this is because some of the firearms seized in a different raid were formerly registered to Congressman Tevez. That is why he was implicated in that charge. Mm. In the other confiscations of explosives and firearms, they have yet to ascertain if Congressman Tevez owned those firearms as well, but they were seized in his properties. So that is why in the statement that the CIDG gave us today, it said that unfortunately Congressman Tevez and Kurt Matthew Tevez were not around during the implementation of the search warrant, but right now the CIDG is working to file cases against these people as soon as possible. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Rafi Santos there joining us on the line. Meanwhile, the new governor of Negros Oriental, Carlo Reyes, officially took over from his slain predecessor, Ruel Degamo. Annie Perez now joins us with that story. Annie, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, the new governor of Negros Oriental was emotional when he took his seat inside the office at the provincial capital of Negros Oriental. He was still in disbelief at what happened to his predecessor, Governor Carlo George John Guido Reyes, even hugged tight the standee of the slain Governor Ruel Degamo. He said that he hopes the death of Degamo will be the start of peace in Negros Oriental. It took some time for Reyes to come to the office and visit the office of Degamo because he is currently recovering from an illness and was even on medical leave when Degamo was slain last March 4. He arrived yesterday afternoon on a wheelchair with his aides assisting him. He told the employees of the Capitol that they should not be sad and they should be strong, and that he also explained that there are no replacements yet except for the position of provincial administrator, where he face Attorney Karen Lizette Molas, and also he changed the provincial legal officer, who is now Attorney Mary Grace Villegas. Apart from these changes, Carmina, no other orders were made by the new governor, but he also mentioned that he will attend the burial of Governor Digamo at his hometown in Chaton this Thursday. Reyes succeeded Digamo after the incident last March 4 at the residence of the governor in Barangay San Isidro in Pamplona town. And the following day, he was sworn into office by Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos in the medical facility in Manila. Reyes also added that he will work as much as Digamo in his capacity, and the person who replaced him, and he ensured a smooth transition in his previous position as vice governor with first board member Manuel Chaco Sagarbaria Jr. And that's the latest here in Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.